Have you noticed that people are asking for updates from each other all the time? Most updates come on email, with attachments, chat, and then after some time you want to know what was the update 4 months back and you have absolutely no idea. So Teams has a solution for this. It has a built-in app called Updates. So let's learn it and become efficient with updates. Go to Teams. Teams menu is on the left side. Click on the three dots and search for updates. You will find this and you will see an icon here. But before we learn about updates, make sure this icon doesn't go away, because by default, if you click somewhere else, that updates is gone. Again, you'll have to go to three dots and do it. Don't do it. So right click on updates and say pin so it doesn't run away. How do updates work? Very simple. Someone requests for an update and someone else provides the update. It's that simple. Now, as a person, you may be on both sides. So here it is showing you two distinct areas. Review means updates which others have submitted for you to review. Currently, there is nothing. And submit means things you can submit. What can you submit? New updates. There are 8 templates to choose from, but you can create your own. Now, someone else has requested something from you, but it is not yet due. Then you will see it as scheduled upcoming. If something is overdue, you will see it here. Many times, updates are just updates and they don't have a deadline. Those will appear here. And things which you have already submitted in the past, they will be seen here. So without struggling, without searching in email and chat and scrolling, you get to see exact status of what has been happening. Now, what can you do? You can request an update or you can just submit a quick update. So let's start with the process of requesting an update. So request an update, click here and choose new request. You can start from blank and build your own update requirements, or you can choose one of the 8 templates. So I'm going to choose Project Progress. This will show you a preview of what is happening. Essentially, it's just a form. There's a text box, there are radio buttons, there are dates. Now I'm going to say, pick this template. Now what happens? This is where you can customize the template. If you want all the defaults, you can just say next, next, next. Otherwise, you can customize it. This is just the name and description. The next step is the actual form. It's a stripped down version of Microsoft Forms. There are updates, percentage complete, blockers, details of blockers, and so on. And finally, if you want to customize this, click on Add New. And you have 3 options: choice, text, and date. So that's how you build the form. I'm just going to go to the next step. And now we have to decide who is going to provide updates. I'm just going to put it for one person right now, who is my assistant. Now there is another role involved. I'm requesting an update, but I may not necessarily be the person who is going to view it. There's nothing like approval here. Update is one way. I give the update and someone looks at it. I'm not going to see it. I'm asking boss to see it. I'm just the assistant who is managing the collaboration at update level. Now, depending on the situation, you can make file mandatory. And then there are some advanced options. Is it a one-time ad hoc update or is it a recurring one? If it is a recurring one, you have daily, weekly, and monthly. One time, it'll just ask you the date and time. Every week, it'll ask you on which days of the week you want it. And then there are check boxes so you can have any schedule and at the time at which this should be due. Similarly, for month, you have to specify the day of the month and the time. So in this case, I'm going to just choose one time. So now I'm going to publish this. What is it saying? The request is ready to use. I can see it here saying Project Progress is requested from whom, who is going to view it, and is it enabled or not. So that's the requesting part of update. Now this is the other user who is expected to give the update. That's the user called assistant. This person may not have the updates app installed at all. So in the activity feed, you will see that Nitin has asked you for an update. So when you click on it, it will ask you the details about the update. And in this case, the form which we had chosen for Project Progress will be rendered here. It also informs me that whatever I submit is going to be viewed by POS. I'm just going to put the default responses and then I'll submit it. This person is assistant. I just submitted an update. I may have done that many times in the past. How do I know what I've done in the past? In my submissions, I will see all the updates in the past. So this is how you submit an update. What will happen? Boss will get an activity feed message saying assistant send an update to view. When boss looks at it, all the details will be shown. This is a read-only view because updates are given by someone and looked at by someone else. All that I can do is look at it, and the only action I can do really is click on the like button. Now, as a boss who is receiving updates, I can see a review as to what is happening here, what is the project progress, and all the updates I have received from different people. So both sides are having much better visibility about sending and receiving updates, and it becomes a seamless zero mail activity. There's another functionality available called quick update, where there's no schedule and all that. It's just an update I want to send to someone. It'll give me some text. I can change it. I can specify viewers, and that's it. And what's new? I'll say test and then submit. In this case, we were inside the update app, which is okay. But suppose I am in a group chat and here I want one of the updates. Now look at this text box. This is just for chatting. There are lots of options here. But if you click on three dots, you will see apps. You can add more apps here, and I will add updates app. Now what happens? Instead of going to the updates app, I am in a chat and I want some request from someone. So I can ask for this, or I can choose from a template. So in the context of a chat or channel, I can do this very quickly. I have some maintenance requests coming up on May 11, so I can also see what is due. So this is how the entire process of requesting and providing updates is completely streamlined in a very simple but effective manner without using a single mail or chat message. So start using it, share it with your team, bosses, colleagues, subordinates, and make everyone more efficient. I also created a video about how to use approvals, which is a two-way process. That means someone requests an approval and someone else grants it. Must have a look at that video as well. So that's it for now. Thank you.